numbers, I guess. The Sacks down here with a big kingdom starting and lots of vassals. The Welsh have Gwynedd and Strathclwyd. The Gaelic kingdom has Sarsen, which are like the Picts, I believe, who have crossbows. That's cool. Meadey, I guess, or Mide, are the Irish over here, competing for the Irish throne. You got the Vikings, the East Angle, the East Angle, and the Northumbria. The Difflin Sea Vikings on the Isle of Man here, at the little foothold in Ireland, and then the Sudreyar up here in Scotland. So, I played a bit of Ireland already, so I'd like to be somewhere over here on the main island. I feel like if I'm these guys, I'm going to be in direct competition with these big boys down here. So what is this? The king of the Danelaw rewards those who raid and conquer in his name. You get missions to fight and unique rewards for your aggression. You get very strong axe infantry. Plus income from raiding and sacking, which I don't generally do. I usually just expand. And who's the other one? The Northumbria. They have a slightly better position here, I think. So the Viking warlord Ragnar was killed by the Anglo-Saxons. Seek revenge for his death. That sounds kind of fun. But he has disloyal characters, which I guess that's just... Oh, I guess they don't. They have rich lands. But let's go with these Northumbria. Yeah, let's give it a shot, why not? For Ragnar, he won't be forgotten. So I haven't played with vassals in this one. Let's see how that works out. Ragnar died here, killed by an English king. How fitting that we now rule his lands. Years the great army ravaged England before we settled the conquered lands of Northumbria. We have carved out a kingdom of our own on an understanding between Viking and English. But it is a fragile alliance, requiring the right king to lead it. If we remain strong, all of England lies open before us. If not, we will follow Ragnar to his grave. Alright, so don't be like Ragnar is the takeaway here. Okay. We got some rebels here to take out. And, we'll just manually fight this to show off the system here. So, it's based heavily on the Attila, like graphics and art style and stuff, but there's a lot of different mechanics at play here. I think the unit diversity, in terms of just how each unit looks, or each man looks in a single unit, is kind of a step back to like the total, or the Rome total. lame, I feel like. But this unit, I guess it's because it's our Warlord's unit. But like, these guys are all pretty similar, I guess. Maybe I'm wrong. The Irish units and the English all looked exactly the same. So the Vikings don't know much about cavalry. Look like, are they also Vikings? Yes, they are. But I don't know, I think this game has its good points. It is more streamlined, which I'll show you with the building later on. But the campaigns usually play out quicker, which is kind of nice. So let's draw them out of formation. All right, now let's go. They didn't even charge their cavalry for some reason. As well. Alright, but I like infantry, so I think we're good with this. Let's charge in and help our king. Alright, he's surrounded now. What's he gonna do? Up. How long can their general last completely surrounded? Yeah, let's stop firing on our own guys here. I'm surprised he's still alive in there. There's some crazy combat going on in here. Surrounded, hopefully we can get him before they get away so that we don't have to fight a second battle. There we go. Okay. I wouldn't imagine there's enough left of them to fight a second battle, but let's see. And also, has a different, like, system going on, which I think is kind of cool. Preemptive strike against the West Moringas. If you are to be the first of a great dynasty that will be long remembered, you will need to integrate yourself into the land you have come to rule by might. The English English are your people now? Okay, so you gotta placate the English. Alright. And we want a champion fighter here. Alright, so diplomacy is a bit different. Or not diplomacy, technology. So you don't build better, like, recruitment buildings. You just have to research them in here to get better units. And everything is global recruitment pool now. You can recruit from anywhere in your territory. Just any unit. And you have to do certain things to unlock the technology, like recruit 10 swordsmen, or spearmen or missiles, or win siege battles, or build certain buildings, or have a high level general, or build a building from a certain chain. So, that's pretty interesting. And each has their own mechanics. Like what we have here, a strong, confident force is far less likely to loot, pillage, and generally abuse the local population. So you have to increase the army's happiness by sacking settlements and taking on warriors after battle. So I gotta have a fightiness like the orcs. And here's where you have to placate the English, I guess. Okay, so there's probably events related to that. And there is war fervor, which affects your happiness and morale and things. So the English had a different mechanic. I played a very little bit about amount as the merchants down here. And they could, like, pay money to increase their loyalty of generals and things. And the Irish had a system where they had to improve their legitimacy to kind of claim the throne of Ireland. So let's see what our loyalty's like. It's not actually terrible, so that's good. Okay, so we're already married. We have a son here who's 15 and 14. That's good. Our food could be a little bit better. Diplomacy is a bit different. Simplified. I think auto trade is already on if you're not at war with someone. So it told us to fight these guys, which seems everyone except the merchants would be happy about. And these guys wouldn't be too happy, but they're not allies, are they? So, who cares what they want? And that would give us 2 more farms. So that would be very good for us. And these are our allies down here. Got the Hilborg and the Holderness. And how many armies do we have starting out? Looks like 2. Army and engage them. So, what do we want? Oh, yeah, and every unit uses food too, so kind of limits how many you can make. Like, we could safely build like 3 more characters now, or units. So, I like those guys. some food. Oh yeah, and about building. So your provinces have like a major settlement that has a garrison, and you can actually have a little bit of flexibility in what you build. But the minor settlements have only a set building type that you can upgrade. So it's kind of back to like the Shogun 2, or mainly a Shogun 2 probably. But what's different is you can capture each one independently, where I think before it was linked to it. Change is when you recruit, they are recruited instantly, but at half health. So, kind of gotta manage that. Make him a scribe, so he's a better governor. Everybody's still happy here. So there's supplies that you have to worry about when you're in enemy territory. Well, this guy's coming right at us. I don't think we're at war yet, but he also did get rid of two of his units. Here. But I'll just go out there to meet him. Get another governor. This province is unhappy with us. The supplies. Alright, let's see what this guy is gonna do. And how attacking him is gonna hurt our reputation with the English. I assume that it's definitely gonna have an effect. And we'll see what my running out of food is gonna have an effect on us. Like, nothing else seems to... I guess quartermaster is still useful. Yeah, actually quartermaster is still a good trait. Reduce upkeep for units in its territory, and just like that. So here, King, roads or drains. You feel secure enough to invest some of your gold in improvements to the land you now rule. But should you think first of your troops and improve the old roads your army uses to move around? Or should you look to the English farmers who provide your food and drain some of the fens to give them more land? I guess what will please the people. It gives us more upkeep, it costs more to recruit, and we are plundered slower. There's raiders, more Viking raiders are coming in from the south. Suspicious here, just walking into your territory. Don't mind me. Okay, is there anywhere that's not happy? They're not really that happy here. Later. Let's see, can you like annex them? No. Oh well. Okay. He's going home, that's good. He's not completely out of our lands, but oh look, there's Hadrian's Wall, parts of it. That's interesting. That's the wall the Romans built. They found the shortest distance across England here and built this wall with tons of border forts. That's really cool that it's there. Vassals are coming in, but oh, we can still get them. Alright, so we do have an advantage. I think that quick saved. There we go, it's at the top. Okay. As revenge, fighting the unbreakable wall. Okay, so they have a little bit more cavalry than us. But I have better cavalry. Got those. Whoops. Let's test that out. They were spread out a bit more, but that's okay. What do our units look like? That's our Thane cavalry and our scout. And do we get any cool units? We have some Thanes here. Where's our big axeman? Some vicious axes. And who else do we have? A sword. Heardman is like our best sword unit. Sucks. How's it going over here? Looks like we won, I think. That they're archers. Destroyed those guys. Yeah, now they know they're in trouble. Broken, so let's bring our guys back in. They're starting to buckle over here. How's it going out here? Looks very like it's going very well. Other spearmen are forming back up. general fight zone here. Where are those arrows? Ragnar's legacy, a slight never erased. You are hearing Ragnar's name a lot these days. He may be gone, victim of the cowardly Anglo-Saxons who had him put to death in a manner that still disgusts you. But what you fought for is what you fight for today. This land is yours by right of conquest, and it is your destiny to expand your borders. Ragnar's name, order your army to occupy a nearby enemy settlement. That will show these curs who the true warriors are. So we gotta conquer Jurjivi, which I just did. And now let's go take this by sea. Just to make sure. street does and won't tell me. I would lose an influence. Okay, so that worked. Let's try and get this guy on our side now. And that just worked right off the bat. So nobody is zero anymore, but we have a lot to be worried about. I'm not sure why everyone hated that. It seems like we were just able to get everything back on track. And now all our generals are disloyal. But what is that big cross on that island? That's kind of cool looking. Playing as the Irish, I didn't have that much trouble. Dang, siege expert's really good. Save just in case somehow this makes everybody pissed. We could subjugate them, could sack it, or just occupy it. Oh, what's that? Your army has shown its might, and you have rewarded them well. Now even those they defeat are often happy to join them. So minus 10% upkeep cost, minus 6% recruitment cost, and plus 10% replenishment. You're being pulled in two directions. Will you listen to your subjects, respecting their ways, and providing the support and aid they ask for? Or will you make your army your focus? Happiness by occupying settlements and ransoming warriors after battle, as long as the enemy aren't English. Okay, the happiness naturally declines. Okay, so we eliminated them, and our war fervor has increased. And increased again. Our war fervor is crazy high right now. Lowest of guys. We could try and find him a wife. No, don't do that. That is a terrible wife. instead of just spending money, you had to spend money and, like, influence points. Oh, the Jerby wannabe friends. Let's see, how does that work out for us? We could, like, I don't know, just annex those guys easily. Over. And we have something in a state that needs governing. No, I guess we already had one. But we need to take over this. Let's see, what can we... What do we want to see here? Is there a way to filter our map? Yet. So do they have any armies in the south? It doesn't look like it. Does anything provide plus loyalty? Doesn't seem so. But it'll go down. Use this time to build up. What else do we need? are still feisty. We have another son that hates us too. Our other army. Gotta get that guy over here as quick as he can. And we should probably just regroup one over here, actually. Which one is our son? With us, since they have no armies down here, and they're already at war with so many. I think we're at war with these guys too, though, since that was their vassal. Thank you. his loyalty next time, I think. But other than that, things are looking up. Also reinforce this army instead of going directly for that, but we'll see. He still has an army fighting like the Picts and the various Scottish tribes up there, or the pre-Scottish. Okay, what do we have to do? Capture Dinpris over here. You are hearing rack. Okay. Well, I think that says the exact same thing. Okay, a fleet of Nordmen. And it's all going wrong in the south, so we'll keep our attentions focused up here. And we should be good. What is the trait? Though in this one. Wow, that's the walls they have. These must be old Roman fortifications. Yeah, that's probably the case. Because there's no way that these guys built those glorious stone walls. This seems more their speed on the inside. Over there and over here. Wonder what the firing range is of those. Because if we just stick right here, we could. Alright. You can't get on those broken wall parts. Sense. Okay, so we'll get those guys up. Get those guys up. Send the ramp straight on in. Keep our general back in the trees, as well as our cavalry. Maybe bring our archers up here. Just get on the walls like they could in previous titles. Who do they have? We have some javelin guys here. here. And then that's all we can see for right now. We could try and just bash in this gate with our face. Let's see how that goes. Just walk it, guys. Take it easy. Arrows. It's doing absolutely nothing. That's very surprising. And they just keep like shuffling them around. I guess it's because they have shields. It's kind of a waste. I don't even know if I should still be doing it. As it is in Warhammer Total War. Looks like they're bringing more guys up here. They're using their Jedi Force push to push that, because clearly no one's doing anything. Oh, here we go. We're up on the walls now. Now they're in trouble. Those axemen in close quarters. Boom. The gates are down. Time for everybody to get on in here. Thank you. This guy's still getting hit, holy crap. Son there. I was thinking about making him a general, but we'll just make him a governor for now. And we can upgrade our axemen. The English are not too happy with us. Which I guess is mainly just these guys. So, we'll Westeros, the province of Westeros over here, is sending its giant slayers. But they've never seen a champion like this guy. Westerness is threatened enough to call back its army from the front. I don't blame them. We encountered the Nordmen. I guess they were successful in their raiding. Yep. They landed and set up their own kingdom right in these guys. So I bet that is the challenge of having such a big kingdom here, is it just keeps sending Viking raiders at you, so you have to call back your troops from the front and put a stop to those guys. Garrisoned. I'm not sure how to check. What is that thing? Not sure. Wait, how much does it cost to buy influence? Looks like we have enough, but 500 more than that, just to be safe. So hold off, but we're making a lot of money. Once we're done with these wars, hopefully we can turn that back into province improvements instead of just troops. But we own Hadrian. just recreate that. That's good. I hope the, I wish the Northumbrians, or the, are they the Norlanders or some weird like that, but I wish them success in their wars to the north. That'll just weaken them and give me more lands to take over. So is that really making them like us less? English rebels really hate us. Ooh, someone took out the westernest place over here. So I guess we'll just grab this little city. Is gone. That gives us 2,000 gold as well. Dang. Okay. Our army loves us now. Now that they know you are on their side, your warriors are proud to serve. They keep themselves on top form, awaiting orders to carry out raids or attack your enemies. So that's good. But our subjects are not too happy. But look at all our money. Our happiness. Let's start keep chipping away at this. Okay. He's happy. And he's happy, so we have some happy nobles now. Thank you. specialist now. Still need, I guess we can do shield effectiveness or melee skill. Let's get that melee skill. Okay, can we upgrade our units? I guess not. Didn't that unlock something? They're separate units. Who'd we unlock? Oh, we can do the shield biters and the Huskarls. They don't even really cost that much. Just do that. And what does he have? Two archers, those guys. I mean, he doesn't need these guys. He's not an elite unit. But we'll get a couple. Uh-oh. We're about to enter another territory there. Strathclot has stuff here. Can we be buddies with them? Looks like it. They like us. Yeah, so that'll do that. A defensive pact. We have buddies up here. We're friends with all these guys. And Strathclot has that, so we gotta run and secure all these lands. And then we'll be good. So, I'm working on making everyone happy. Okay. Actually, I should probably upgrade food instead of that. There's a rebel taking that too from Strathclot, it looks like. So we might have the ability to conquer that as well. as the sun. Let's do quartermaster. I'm making myself real popular up here. Let's start going this way. Oh, they've established a kingdom over there. Okay, soon they'll be crushed. We could make use of this army and send it down here, but I might just bring my general down there. Because after this goes away, secure up here with these two guys. Our rebellious is that new guy. Okay, he's due. It's not too concerning. don't have to worry about it. All right. Ostrad Glut wants an alliance. For 100 gold, that's fair. I'm not sure why they tacked that on there. So we'll wait for that. Whose loyalty is low? Harold again. Harold's the freaking worst. Should we just disband him? He's done his duty. Boom. Blew the axe out of his hand, or the shield. Straight for him. Okay, brought that back into the fold. And can we just get rid of him? Or is he gonna be permanent, even if we disband him? Is Harold still gonna be here? Yeah. What a turd. Oh, since he's moving jobs, I can't do enough. Assassinate him. See if we can take that from them. Wait, did they actually? Did that faction steal a province from them? Yeah, they actually took a little province. And that faction popped up there. We're with Weising. Okay, hopefully all the East Angles aren't disintegrating. Face of all these enemies. Only Northumbria will survive. I hope that captures that, because that big city would be cool. It's so long away though. Yeah. Assholes are on the move with a big army. They're gonna expand their domain. I'm okay with that. I don't have any plans on heading in that direction. Not content with holding the port at Difflin, the Viking Sea Kings, who settled on Area's east coast, have made a move on their result is the same. Difflin now controls Brega's territory. Okay, there was flooding somewhere. Let's fix that. Sack it or just capture it. We'll just keep our Viking tradition going. Let's get him walking around the coast there. Obviously.